Hey, what up, YouTube? Major G. I just woke up, so it might look a little funny. But I woke up to news that the brand new Power Ranger movie trailer just came out. I'm actually a fan of Power Rangers. I prefer Super Sentai a little bit more. And Super Sentai are the original. Is what Power Rangers is based on, which is a Japanese franchise. On the surface, it looks like the same thing, but Super Sentai often has a lot of deeper storylines and stuff like that. And oddly enough, it's argued that the whole Super Sentai franchise can be linked back to the back in the 70s, in the late 70s, Marvel licensed two live action series of Spider-Man. Now, oddly enough, the American version was the accurate version, or quote unquote the accurate version, which had Peter Parker. He lived in New York. He swung around New York, all that stuff. That was the American version. No one remembers the American version. Which I find kind of funny. However, then there's the Japanese version of Spider-Man, Spider-Man, which the main character is a Japanese guy named, I forget the guy's name, the character, I forget the Japanese character's name, but he like rides a motorcycle and he like does a henshin or a transformation into Spider-Man, as opposed to like it being a costume. And Spider-Man has, and that version of Spider-Man has a flying car and a giant robot. And then that's the one that actually ended up becoming legendary, which oddly enough is also the only Spider-Man that where the main character is not Peter Parker. So, or not only Spider-Man. The only, it's the only Spider-Man franchise outside of the comics where the main character is not Peter Parker. There we go. That's what I meant. In the comics, you have Spider-Man where the main character isn't Peter Parker. You have Dr. Octopus, you have Miles, Morales, you have Ben Reilly, and you have Gwen Stacy. So yeah, then those and yeah, I think Spider-Man, I think Peter Parker has his own comic. But those are the Spider-Men without their own comics, or with their own comics. However, in the motion picture world, where pictures are moving and stuff. I mean by that, instead of like movies, in any edition of motion pictures, television, cartoon, live action, there's only ever been one Spider-Man where the main character was not Peter Parker. And I say that, and I say it in that way because, because the old 90s Spider-Man had, I want to say they did the Clone Saga, and then Ultimate Spider-Man had Miles Morales. So those are the only but in their series, Peter Parker starred in those, or Peter Parker was the main character. Whereas in Spider-Man, Peter Parker was not the main character. It was a Japanese guy, and once again, I forget the character's name. Anyway, but yeah, it's argued that that is where the whole, because Japanese TV generally only does one season of anything. There are a couple of exceptions out there. There's more than one season of Goku-sen. There's more than one season of the newest Great Teacher Onizuka series. There's more than one season of what's the name of that series? Kenpachi Sensei. And of course, anime has more than one season. Excuse me, once again, I just woke up. So they wanted to keep that whole thing going for more than one season. So then that's when you got into Kamen Rider. And then I believe Kamen Rider helped give birth to what we know as Power Rangers or Super Sentai. And Super Sentai has been going on since the very late 70s or early 80s. And America picked up on it in the early 90s. And that's when Saban licensed it and turned it into a series called Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. I am actually a fan of Power Rangers. I'm not as big as I should be. I haven't seen as much of it as I should, but I am aware of pretty much all of the seasons. And Power Rangers, believe it or not, is still running. It's been going almost nonstop since the early 90s. I think the Saban years, the Haim Saban years they had like three or four seasons of Mighty Morphin. Then there was Zeo, Turbo, Power Rangers in Space, Lost Galaxy. Then it was Lightspeed Rescue? I want to say Lightspeed Rescue. And then Time Force. Wild Force. Then was Ninja Storm. Dino Thunder. SPD. Oh, by the way, sorry. Once Light Force Rescue came in, that was when Disney took over. So Disney took over for something like 10 or 15 years or something like that. So from Lightspeed Rescue all the way up to, I believe it was, I want to say RPM. The RPM Rangers. Or it was either RPM or Jungle Fury, whichever was... Yeah, I think it was RPM or Jungle Fury. And believe it or not, I personally prefer the Disney seasons because I feel like the Disney seasons have a much better... Wow, okay, I'm on 8 minutes. Because the Disney seasons, I feel, have kind of brought more to that table of what Power Rangers... Or what... of or cross that bridge between Power... It was closer to Super Sentai than it was the old Power Rangers because they did it pretty much almost exactly like the Japanese series did, which was all of those were one season each, and they had completely different casts for each season. And Saban didn't do that. Like, they initially started with the regular, with the Mighty Morphin, and kept them for like three or four years, and then merged some of them into Zeo, and then merged some of them into Turbo, and it was completely different. And the storylines were, I felt, a lot more goofy. But once they went into space, I hear that that's when it really started picking up. I definitely stopped when Turbo came about because I thought that was lame because they had a little kid that became a full-grown adult. Anyway. Yeah. All right. I'm going to get into this reaction because I've already been talking long enough. So let's get into this. Power Rangers, the official movie teaser trailer. Which is supposed to be a reboot of the of the original series. So they're supposed to have all the original characters played by different actors. But yeah, let's see how this goes. Here we go.
To remind me of my screw up?
You know, I don't think we're ever gonna understand each other.
They're gonna come here and
actually
just
looks like
with all these other weirdos and criminals.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep.
So, this is where you come every Saturday instead of practice. Tragic.
I keep the ends out for the tie that binds.
Hey! It's a restricted area!
Guys?
There's something in there.
That can really be
Dilly.
Guys!
What is it?
Oh, there's no Zordons?
Somebody should have pointed that out. Wait, I did.
You know something happened up there, okay? I'm not the same.
I'm strong.
How strong?
I'm insanely strong.
No.
Bam! I feel like we need to go back up there.
I'm gonna jump across with her, and then you jump.
Yeah, they're definitely going on with the old one.
No, don't jump! Jason! That's not a piece of cake!
New suits. All right. So, I don't know what to think about this. they're definitely going in a completely different direction than ever before. Well, no, I don't mean ever before. I mean with the series. You see, in the Sentai Power Ranger series, they always have some. There's always some sort of guide character to tell them what they're supposed to do. And these guys look like they're going to be on their own, which makes it. I don't know. Yeah. So for some of you younger guys, in the old Power Ranger series, there was a character named Zordon. And Zordon was like stuck in a tube or something like that. So all you saw was his face. And, Zordon was, he was their guide. He was their guide character. He would tell them what they needed to do. And how they needed to do it, like how, you know, in case they were lost or anything, he'd provide guidance. And these guys definitely looked lost. Now, what I meant by what, they were going kind of with the old way, which was that in the, was it the Saban series? Because I feel like they did that in Dino Thunder too. In the old Saban series, the Power Rangers, the original series, I believe they did actually have superpowers, like untransformed. And, they had superpowers when they were untransformed, if I remember correctly. And the suits gave them even more powers, I think it was. They just didn't showcase it a lot, but I think they established at very early on that that before they were even transformed, they had powers. And that was just from even having access to the morphing grid or something like that. So this is definitely showing that. But they're In the old series, they were also more goody-goody. Like, they weren't troublemakers. Like, Billy was a straight-up nerd. Kimberly was, like, an A student who was in gymnastics. And, who was the name? Jason was just an all-around leader, if I remember correctly. Like, he was, I think he was a, he might have been a jock, but he was, like, a good jock. So, but, yeah, this is, I don't know, I'll have to see more of what this is about, because they're kind of going in a different direction than, and I think I'd heard that they were going in a different direction, more with the whole remake kind of way that they're going nowadays. Almost like, no, I'm not going to bring that up, because that's, apparently that is like there's a newer series that that's like, but this is, I don't know what to feel about this movie. Yeah, I'll have to think about that. But yeah. Let me know what you guys think. Like, comment, subscribe, all that stuff. And, share, talk about it in the comments. And until next time, I will see you guys later.
Relax. We got this.
They know each other. Whoa! Was that Damien?
Explored an unruly tribe. Together, you are the best crew a captain ever.
Sorry, contact you like this, Captain Hunter.
Super crew!